Besides all of that, I just want you to understand the concept of just moving with hands up instead of doing this without, you know, so you won't just concentrate on your legs moving, but actually with your hands going at the same time, okay? So how are we going to do that? First of all, let's put our arms out like this. Just going to chop. Without hitting, just chop. Boom. Okay, I think there's a blade right here. Down. Down. Keep your arms up. Boom. Boom. Okay? This motion. Here. Out. Here. Here. Down. Not easy, huh? Boom. Up. Chop. Chop. Boom. Okay? Let's just do this for a little bit. Alright, I'm going to demonstrate a little bit for you. Say we're going to hit, right? Boom. Just going side to side. Boom. Hands first. Leg. Bop. Hands first. Leg. Hands first. Leg. Okay? Get kind of the idea. It's a little bit abstract. So the thing is, it's in the beginning, think of hand first, then leg. Just step, step, boom, using the arm. Boom. So after you get used to this, you don't have to just stay like this. You know what I'm saying? You can switch, then chop, boom, cap, turn. It's just keeping the arms up in an angle like this for now, in the beginning. Okay? So basically, just keep your arms up in an angle. It's like the sword arm angle. That's what it is. Like this. Okay? So once you get good at this, once you're comfortable dancing with the footwork, whatever you're doing, but with this going on, now we're going to add, think about the tuts. Think about the angle of the tuts going like this. Boom. So how are we going to think about it? So let's put a tut up like this. Top. Right? So let's say we're going here, here, right? So adding this, so let's say we go boom, with the tuts, boom, with the tut, boom, 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 cap, cap, then go into the sword arm, then back to the tut, boom, 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 trying to get the idea, it's just mixing the angle. So the more angle you know, obviously the better it's gonna look. So how are we gonna know even more angle? It's just exploring. It's impossible for me to just show you now left and right. I mean, I don't even wanna do that. There's no point to do that. So once you get good at all that, let's say, think about turning your wrist. So once we get the sword arm from here, and then switching the touch, boom, ka, ka, boom, 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 okay? Think about turning the wrist. So what I mean by turning is this. Okay, remember in the basic turning DVD, just learn how to turn. So we'll add that to it. So let's say we're cutting, boom. See how I just turn it? Boom. Boom. Turn. Angle. Chop. Turn. Angle. Boom. Okay, so this section, I really want to just kind of check it out and see if when you're dancing, are you putting your arms up or are you doing this? Or you just stay, once you get out of this Fresno position, are you just relaxing? Okay? Think about moving on your hands. Obviously this gesture, boom. Okay, your hand is dancing as much as your feet. Okay, even though if you're just going side to side, boom. Still dancing, okay? Still turning. Boom. Wow. Tap. Still turning. Still doing the angle. Boom. So think about that. So how are you gonna practice that when you're dancing? Pay notice on the sword arm, on the angle of the tuts, adding that. Boom. Adding the turn. Turning is when you're rolling the legs. It's good. Or when you're taking a step, add a little bit more layer to it. Alright, so once you know that, we're going to add a little bit more even with the footwork, with the hits. So the footwork with the hits is just give you better isolation and just staying still. Okay, and what I'm going to talk about is these kind of motions. When I'm going like this, boom, cap, cap, boom, 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 yeah, I'm just staying still. But it looks like I'm doing a lot of isolation. Okay, so how are we going to do that? Check it out. First of all, think about the leg. You're gonna step out, bring it back. Step out, bring it back. Okay? Now we're gonna go on the ball of the feet like this. Bring it back. Ball of the feet, bring it back. So once you get to here, we're gonna do a little bit of Elvis, knuckle Elvis. Now we're gonna row, bring it back. It's an isolation right there. Here, bring it back. Boom. Tap. Tap. Let's do a lift like this. Step. Here. Here. Boom. Tap. Boom. So when we are coming in, make sure you have this closing. Boom. So your feet will be a little bit on the side. So we got here. Boom. Tap. Here we go. Again, slow. Step out. Boom. Tap. Tap. Step. Step. Boom. Tap. One more time, slow. Here we go. Step here, here, row, stepping, side. So I can also turn as well. Sometimes add a little bit more flavor to it. All right. Once you know the feet, we're gonna add the body. So what is the body? Obviously, a lot of placing, which for my animation DVD. Boom, boom. And also shoulder. Shoulder going like this. Boom. So here we go. Let's say the shoulder first. Boom. Rolling back. Rolling forward. Rolling forward. Rolling back. Legs. Roll back. Boom. So once this comes, bring the chest up. Boom. Okay, here we go. So let's go from hands, slowly. Hands. Shoulder. Legs. Rolling back. Boom. The other leg. Cut. Boom. So let's say you're going to bring it down. Which is bringing it down, tap, then go, boom, tap, So what does this do for you is when you're home practicing, practice this, practice the sword arm. After that, work on just staying still, isolating. Forward, forward, back, chest, bring it down to the hips, side, tap, step, boom, tap. So practice these just basic isolations. Just to give it a little bit more, I mean, always bring it in. Just all really basic practicing. When we're doing this, it's just a roll. Rolling like that. So shoulder go back, shoulder go front. It's just this. On front and back. Okay? Just also can bring it back in here. Okay, this is just give you a good habit of like moving your arm and your legs together. So practice that.